To create a new invoice, all that we have to do is click on the green plus button to the right of the purchaser for whom we want to create an invoice for. You can also click on the green plus button if you're on one of these individual pages showing all of the invoices for a specific purchaser. It's going to pull up the exact same form. So in here, you can see that it's got some of these presets that I already put in, so it knows that we're making an invoice from the 16th to the 1st. The one thing I didn't have set on this purchaser settings is a timestamped event. So we're going to click unload date, click create invoice, and what it'll do is it will put a new line in here. We can see that we have now created the 21.1.2, so 2021 January, the second invoice of the month for Bravo Energy Corp or BEC. You can see the timestamps in here. And you'll remember when I created this that it was set in Central Time, but because my computer is in Mountain Time, it'll automatically show what it would be on my computer. So it's from 11 p.m. Mountain Time to 6 a.m. instead of from like midnight to 7. It'll automatically do those calculations for you, so you don't have to really worry what your computer is set in. But you can see right here that so far this invoice has not been approved, not been submitted, not been factored, not been paid. If I were to click on these as we go through the process, I could mark it as approved, and it'll show the total and the date and the person who did it, and I can undo that as well. So this page gives you a great status of if you have multiple invoices in here, you can see where they are in the invoicing process as they've been approved by the person making them, whether or not they've been submitted to the customer, if they've been factored out or paid. But let's go ahead and view this invoice. And in here, you can see that there's quite a few different tabs that we're going to go over. This first tab, you can see up at the top, and this is above all tabs, there's a back button, a refresh invoice totals, and a refresh all tickets. So the back button just takes us back to this main page. The refresh invoice totals will refresh this number right here, the totals as well as the subtotals down here. Obviously, if I do this right now, there won't be any changes because we just barely created this invoice, so it's fresh, nothing's changed. And then there's the refresh all tickets option. So this is usually a good idea to do before you get started and when you're kind of wrapping up to make sure there haven't been any like last minute changes on a ticket that changes some of the pricing. So if I click on that, you can see that it'll take a little bit right here. And you'll notice that this other button went from green to red. That's because LoadCall has detected that these tickets have been updated. They may not have changed, but they definitely have updated. And so after this is done, we'll want to go ahead and click on the refresh invoices total as well to get it go back to green. And this will be red anytime you open it up if a ticket's changed anywhere in the software, not necessarily in invoicing. If somebody over has changed something on it, LoadCall smart enough to know that you should probably refresh your invoice totals. So we'll go ahead and do that. So the button goes back to normal, but as nothing changed, these numbers are kind of the same. So let's go over this kind of this first tab right here, the summary section. Up here, you can see that we have the invoice's name, the invoice total, the invoice date, the date that it was created, which if we need to change that, we can, you know, backdate it or whatever, or forward date it, who we're billing out to, the date range that is covered by this invoice, the total tickets, deleted tickets, and errors on tickets. So right now, it looks like we have 6 tickets that have errors on them. In a different segment of this video, I'll go over how to kind of troubleshoot some of those, since that can be kind of a tricky part to do. But we'll go ahead and do that in a bit. But down here, you can see that we have a progress checklist. This is the same as back out on the front, where you have approved, submitted, factored, and paid. So in here, you can do it as well, approved, submitted, factored, and paid. So if I click on it, it'll put my name and a timestamp. And back on the main page, you can see that we have now progressed in our invoice. However, we're kind of premature on that, so I'm going to undo that for now. And this next section right here, in order to kind of troubleshoot some of these tickets, we would need to load in the ticket analysis and ticket review section, which I'll do in the next segment. But down here at the very bottom of the summary tab, you can see some line items in here, the broken subtotals of how this $21,000 total was made. So you can see that we're charging for chain up, fuel surcharge, a mask up fee, our line haul, the rate per barrel summed up, the receiver wait time, reject load, shipper wait time, split sites, etc. And you can see that right here, we only really have our line haul and our receiver wait time as the two that actually had a total. So probably based on the rates there. But yeah, that's the summary tab. So in the next segment, we'll continue talking about some of the next parts of working on an invoice.